Hi, I'm Nathan Jurevicius, and I'm a multidisciplinary artist. And today I'm going to show you how to create your characters. If you want to learn more about me and my process, you'll find the link to my Domestika course in the description below. Now, when I'm creating my artwork, I use the mouse for everything. A lot of people think I'm crazy for using the mouse, because it seems like it would make more sense to use a Wacom or a pen. But for me, it's as simple as using a pencil. I'll be using grayscale when I'm working in Illustrator. And now the reason why I use grayscale is it allows me to look at the contrast and the shadows before I bring it to Photoshop.
This is the part where we get deep into actually making a really nice structure using shapes and lines in Adobe Illustrator program. Now, I use Illustrator relatively basic. I tend to focus on path tool here. Sometimes I'll play around with the align and transform tools. I use the pen tool here mostly, and then occasionally play around with rotation and the reflect tool. But really my main focus is using the pen tool here. And the pen tool, as you can see, creates all sorts of shapes. And you may be very familiar with this, but that's what I use. So in my layers over here, you can see that I've already got a couple of extra layers happening here. I'm going to actually rename the artwork layer to insects. And those insects are going to be on a separate layer so that when I'm importing or trying to kind of navigate the page in Illustrator, I can easily go to these different layers, just like you would with Photoshop or any other program that deals with layers. So, with that being said, I'm going to just start with my technique and I'll just talk you through it. So, you can see here that as I'm working Illustrator over the light sketch, then play around with just doing little segments. I don't have to accurately go over. The sketch is really there as a backdrop, as sort of a basic template, but it's not there as gospel. You don't necessarily need to follow it exactly. And as I'm working, I look at things and I will look at a piece and think, okay, maybe I want to add some more detail. So what's not drawn there, I might go, oh, okay, maybe I want to add some little like spikes or little tendrils on the legs. And these are the sorts of things that when I'm drawing, the drawing might be so small that I can't get these details. But with Illustrator, I can zoom right up. I can add these really lovely, fine details to the legs, and it's something that is much harder to create when you're working just as small scale. You can't really get these really fine details. When I'm in Illustrator, there's no issue with resolution, and so I can then create these beautiful little extra details.
So you can see here that I'm beginning to work up the image using the Bezier curves, creating shapes and starting to form the images. And what I do is I create the individual shapes of my characters or whatever the environment that I'm creating, and I tend to build up the shapes one at a time. Sometimes I copy and paste the shapes, sometimes I create the original shapes for every element. You can see here that I've sometimes reduced the opacity so I can actually see the shapes that I'm covering when I'm creating the different vector shapes. And what I like to do is basically build up the character so that its own little individual segments. And that means that I can actually just adjust each of these without actually joining them all together. I find that if I start combining shapes into one shape, then I have a harder time breaking up the image into individual shapes and being able to adjust the light and dark areas of them.
You can see here that I've created the first centipede. Now, one thing you'll notice is that I don't use outlines on my artwork. One of the things that I mostly do is just create shapes. So you can see here that there's no actual outlines, it's all shapes. I mean, if you wanted to do that, you could just go over to here and you could add some line work if you wanted to, and you could make all the images and all the shapes have outlines. From here, I look at the image and I think, well, I probably will add some extra fine details. But essentially, this is the way that I slowly work over time and create my image. Now, when I go to here, I can actually lock this layer off, the insects layer off, and I might call this insect one, and I just know then I can keep working and not affect this every time. If I try to move it, it won't move, and then I can create a new layer here and call that insect two. And so then I'll start working on this one. And so eventually I'll start building up the entire image in this way, creating separate layers and individually making a large image.
I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please subscribe to this channel. And if you want to learn more about me and my process, check out my course on Domestika.